Am I the a-hole stories? Am I the a-hole for telling my sister my dad is not her dad? I'm 18 male and pretty conflicted. I have a half-sister, 14 female, from a different father. My father and mother were together for a bit and they had me. The relationship did not work out, but they are on good terms. Later on, my mother had a one-night stand and got pregnant with my sister. Unfortunately, he was a deadbeat and left my mom to fend for herself. My father and I have a very close relationship, and based on the custody agreement, my father has me on weekends and 2 months in summer. My father is also very wealthy and he has put me into a private school and is paying for my university. My father comes often to her house and my sister really tries to force herself upon us. She even tried calling him dad for a bit. When I go to my dad's house, she always wants to come but we don't let her. She is always trying to find some one-on-one time with my dad. He always kindly refuses. When we go on vacation together, she tries to hop on and sometimes we do let her, and she acts like she is his daughter. My father recently got me a car for college. My sister and I were talking recently about the car, and she asked me when dad was going to buy her car. I told her he was not her dad, he was mine. He has never tried to be a parent to you. He comes for all my important events and has never been to one of yours. He put me into a private school while you go to public. I am getting my university paid for and she would not get that luxury. I'll admit I reacted harshly, but I wanted her to wake up to reality. She has since been crying a lot. Especially when my father comes over because she now sees he comes for me and not her. My mother can't afford therapy and she is struggling. My father told me while I was correct, I could have been more tactful. A friend of mine think I am an a-hole. Now for the top comments. No a-holes here. You were harsh, but under the circumstances, I can see why you would be frustrated. Could you have been kinder? Yes, but the ultimate fault lies with your mother. She can't be unaware of the way your sister tries to push herself on your father. Even if she is not encouraging this behavior, she needs to be the one to step in and make it clear to your sister that she has a different father, and that she can't expect your father to see her as a daughter. Your sister is not an a-hole for wanting a father figure, but she needs to accept that your father does not see her as a second child. This needs more upvotes. Mom should have been helping her daughter on this issue a long time ago. No a-holes here. You're the a-hole not for what you said, but how you said it. She's 14, there was no need to point out every single thing she is missing out on by not having a dad. You can call her to reality without being cruel. Also, I wouldn't be shocked if your mom started to spend more time and pay more attention to your sister than you. She clearly needs it more. You're 18, basically an adult, and you went after a child about something she clearly is hurting over in one of the most cruel ways. You are the one that needs therapy. I'm so surprised at how many people seem to be okay with how cruel he was to this child. She is just a sad little girl who was dealt a crap hand in life and is struggling to understand and come to grips with it. I can't imagine how confusing this situation would be for a child growing up. Plus, on top of it all, she has a big brother who clearly has no empathy for her and comes off a bit as if he thinks he's better than her. It just really breaks my heart. You're the a-hole. Check your privilege. You've been set up for a successful life with all the bells and whistles, while the sibling you live with can't even get much needed healthcare. And then your clarification for why you may be the a-hole, you told her she would be forever alone and in debt because you are his real child. Jesus, you aren't just the a-hole, you are cruel too. Your father has set a very poor example for you if this is how you feel entitled to treat people. You're the a-hole. Here's your sister's reality. She wants a father. She can't even get the healthcare she needs. You are living with so much privilege over her, and then to throw stuff like going to public school in her face? You're a terrible brother. Learn some freaking tact. Now for the next story. Am I the a-hole for not letting my kids play with my eldest son's PS5? My son Adam is 16 and for a while he's wanted to get a PS5 for himself. He started working part-time on weekends at a friend's car wash, and saved up enough to buy it a few months ago. It's practically his baby. He keeps it clean, treats it delicately and keeps it in his room. I have two younger sons, Peter, 11, and Stephen, 9. They have both asked Adams if they could also have a turn to play his PS5, but he's always said no. And it's not that Adam is trying to be selfish, I love my boys but they are both huge klutzes. He lets them play his Xbox and I can't tell you how many times they have dropped those controllers getting too into their games or fighting over whose turn it is. He let Peter use his laptop once to watch videos. And after being told not to walk around with the laptop, He did anyways, going downstairs to get a snack while still watching something on the laptop. He tripped and messed up the screen. We went to get it repaired. Don't worry, Peter got in trouble for not listening to what we said, but Adam was still pretty upset about it. So to me, I understand why he doesn't want to share this with them, but my wife feels he's not being fair with his siblings in giving them a chance. She's talked to Adam about sharing his game, he still doesn't want to, and since he bought it with his own money, he feels he should be allowed to decide who plays with it. And honestly, I agree. He wanted the game for himself, got a job to save up for it. So, I told my wife to let him have this, and it's not the end of the world if the boys don't get to play the PS5. They have their own games. Now she thinks I'm being an A for thinking it's not wrong that he's refusing to share with his brothers. And obviously the boys are going to feel left out. But again, don't see how that's the end of the world when they have other stuff to do. Am I being an A for feeling this way? Not the A-hole, he paid for it and they've proved to not take care of things. She can buy a family console if she feels so strongly. Yeah, especially not the A-hole, since this is teaching the kids to set and follow healthy boundaries. If it was a community item, then sharing is a must. No one should have to share their own things. Not the A-hole in the slightest. As a teenager myself, I can tell you the feeling of buying your first somewhat expensive thing after saving and working your butt off for it. And if you don't want someone to do anything with that, especially little brothers, it's your choice. I'd say to keep defending the eldest son and talk to your partner. Oh, and this was expensive indeed. So I understand that feeling of working hard for that first big purchase. I know my sons don't do this intentionally, but they're kids and accidents happen. This is also a great way for the younger ones to learn to respect other person's property and understand the idea behind consent. Not the a-hole at all. It's his PS5, not the family's. He made the money, he gets to spend it as he wishes, and that's his personal property and everyone needs to respect that. You are most certainly not the a-hole here. God, this reminds me of an AITA post about a mother wanting to confiscate her son's gaming PC, at least I think it was a PC, may have been a console, I can't remember. Her point was the fact that her son was under 18 and had done something wrong, she had the right to take away the possession that he bought with 100% his own money. She even admitted she was proud of the fact that he had previously earned and saved every penny for it. Then she was shocked that people were pissed off at her, because he's under 18 and I'm his guardian, everything that's his is technically mine. Absolutely disgusting. Incidents like this when growing up is what makes people cut off family at the soonest opportunity. Next story is titled, Am I the A-hole for not keeping it fair between my daughters? Okay, so I, 36 male, am a lawyer and my wife, 37 female, is a boxing coach, so we both pull up a decent income and we have two daughters, Annie, 14 female, and Judy, 14 female. We give them an allowance of $75 a month each for doing chores. Annie likes art very much and she will draw portraits and sell it for a good price, so she pulls up some more money, like $300 a month on average, so she gets more spending money as compared to her sister Judy, who isn't into anything that much. So, the issue started recently when Judy started complaining to me that Annie gets more money and it is not fair, so I mentioned to Judy that she can also take up a job if she wants, but she said that she will have less spare time. Please note that I offered to pay for any class if she wants to attend it so she can learn something new, but Judy doesn't like this idea also. My wife and I told her that we can pay her extra if she does more chores, but apparently this is also not okay with Judy, as the extra money we will pay her still can't match the amount Annie makes. Now, Judy told my sister, 23 female, about this, and my sis told my mom, and my mom told my mother-in-law. Now both my family and my wife's family are mad at me and wife for not simply giving Judy more money to match Annie's monthly income. There are two reasons why can't we do this. 1. My wife and I are not that rich to simply give Judy $300 for nothing. 2. It will impart bad morals to both Judy and Annie. So Reddit, am I the a-hole? Edit, thank you everyone for the advice and the judgment you gave, and yeah, some comments are implying that Judy is lazy or talentless, but this is not true. Judy is an A student and she is very good in sports, but the thing is that, these things will only start fetching you money once you are of a certain age. So yeah, my daughter is not lazy and she does get prizes from me if she achieves something like best grades or medals in sports, which is pretty common. Now for the top comments. Not the a-hole. Judy wants a handout for doing nothing in order to put her on an equal playing field with Annie. You are being fair if you continue to give them both $75. Think about it like this, I'm a lawyer as well, Hell, it is not fair that I have to live off my salary while Jeff Bezos gets his billions. Someone should equalize it for me. Annie gets more money and it is not fair. Yes, Annie gets more, but not from you. Judy has an opportunity to get some too if she had the desire. I agree, the analogy sucks. Annie works to make extra money. Judy wants extra money too, but without wanting to spend extra time and effort. The family sounds abusive for sending a ton of flying monkeys on OP. Is there some favoritism going on that has made Judy so entitled? Not the a-hole. Annie has earned her extra money, Judy has not. She is acting entitled. OP just needs this one reply. Life lesson for entitled daughter: you want more than work for it. Not the a-hole. It would be unfair on Annie if you started giving Judy the same money she works for but without having to do anything for it. Also, Judy doesn't need a $300 monthly allowance. That's a lot. Not the a-hole, unless you're the one buying her art. She works for her money to have more money. That is how most economic systems work. It is perfectly fair that one child has a job and has more money. Now for the last story. Am I the a-hole for excluding my son from the will? I, male 55, have always had a troubled relationship, male 29. He was rude and had a narcissistic disposition. This was diagnosed by a therapist when he was 14. He always treated us as if we were beneath him. This was the same with his teachers and friends. However, my son was incredibly talented. He got into MIT and is currently making over $500,000 a year. We also have a daughter, female 26. She was abused by our son and tried to keep up with his standards. She didn't do as well as our son and ended up at a community college. We had to put her through years of therapy in college and she has come to accept everyone is different. We are incredibly proud of her. The rest of our family think our son is the golden child of the family, but they are heavily mistaken. He helps out our relatives with financial problems but will brag about it for the next year. He'll be like, "Remember, you were so broke, and if it were not for me you would be on the streets. I'm a godsend." My son is married and has already had his first son. He has mellowed down from his narcissistic tendencies ever since he got married. His wife is a leading neurobiologist and is brilliant. She is kind and has done wonders for him. He has even started donating to charity and I've heard from my family that he is perfect in every way and we should be proud of him. I do acknowledge he has changed and I am happy for him. My wife and I are getting old. While we are not going to fall off the wagon anytime soon, we need to be prepared. We don't have a lot. We have our family home in the suburbs worth around $100,000 in our retirement funds. We have agreed and put the house in our daughter's name and whatever is left from our retirement funds. This is mainly because my son already owns a $2 million house and drives a Mercedes and Porsche with a combined 7-digit household income. Somehow my son has found out about the will and approached me. He said he was upset that he was not considered a part of the family and written out of the will. He claims he has as much of a right to the family home as his sister. He says he shouldn't be punished because of his sister's lack of success. My daughter-in-law also expressed disappointment in us, which really breaks my heart as she is an angel. My son doesn't want our grandson to be around us because he doesn't want to feel second best. This is breaking my wife's heart because she loves him. My brother called me an a-hole for prioritizing my daughter, but no one understands that my son can take care of himself. My wife wants to rewrite the will and I am conflicted. Not the a-hole. I don't believe he's changed at all. His reaction still sounds like the manipulation of a narcissistic person. If it's possible, rewrite the will in a way that leaves him the most minuscule thing possible that he can't legally contest at all. That way your daughter's inheritance is protected from him. I don't believe he's changed at all. His reaction still sounds like the manipulation of a narcissistic person. I believe he has changed, and I do not say this lightly. He didn't raise his voice at me or try anything cunning. He truly had a look of disappointment. I tried to explain to him, but he didn't have it. Daughter-in-law was pretty upset as well. If anything, I saw more rage in her eyes than his. They have now decided not to allow access to our grandchild. They sound like they're well matched. Wealthy and only want to be wealthier. If the house is important to him, then he can buy it from his sister after you've passed. Your son and his wife need to understand that your will is not a sentimental document through which you declare your love for your children. It's a practical document that benefits your daughter, only because your son is already stinking rich. If he can't accept that, I don't think he's recovered from his narcissism quite as much as you think, especially considering the fact that his interpretation of your decision is that he's being punished for his sister's lack of success. That is incredibly unkind. Offer him things you have related to his childhood, or choose some things for him to include in your will so he can't contest it. At the end of the day, it's your money and your house to give away, he does not have any automatic right to any of it. I'd say your first priority is the welfare of your daughter, so don't let him play his games and blackmail you emotionally by withholding his son. He needs to realize the damage he's done and the damage he's doing. His wife may have been able to tone down his worst narcissistic behavior, but that doesn't mean it's gone. Not the a-hole. I understand that my daughter is my priority. When my son moved out for college, he took all the things he loved with him. We had a grandfather clock, but it broke and we've gotten rid of it. I'm racking my brain trying to think of things which will hold sentimental value to him, but there is nothing I can find. I think my only option is to talk to his wife and hope to convince her that we are looking for our daughter's future. But if that does not work, I will be upfront with my wife that she will never have a relationship with her grandson and that many members of our family will resent us, but we have to keep our daughter number one. For safety, I will put a little money for him so he cannot contest the will, but I doubt he will. Not the a-hole. My father is the eldest of four children, but also the objectively financially best off. His father left his inheritance to every other sibling and my father didn't care at all. Even he knew they needed it more. Narcissism aside, you've just made a rational decision. Thank you. I need time to heal the wounds now. And that's it for this video, guys. If you have thoughts to share, leave a comment below. Don't forget to hit like and subscribe if you like this content. I'll catch you in the next one. Good day, everyone.